One of the most demanding circuits on the calendar. We're back here in Monaco, ready for another weekend of classic motorsport action. Plenty of data to find here in practice. A very warm welcome.
They told you about the new parts that have come in from the factory, right? Well, they're all fitted and good to go. I hope they do the trick. Okay, track's green right now, so take a few laps to get the tyres up to temp and get yourself in the zone. Approaching the DRS zone, watch your MFD for the activation point. Okay, give us some good, consistent laps, please. We're looking for good data that we can work into a race strategy. Okay, this is a quali sim. We've estimated the times our closest rivals will be doing, so that's what we need to beat.
And if today's practice is anything to go by, we're in for an exceptional weekend of Formula One. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix. A proper road race, and in the true meaning of the word. That's how Mr. Monaco, the late great Graham Hill, once described this iconic event. The cars we drive have come a long way in the intervening half century, but still we race on those same public roads beside the Mediterranean. There's no victory more coveted than that of the Monaco Grand Prix. The astonishing Circuit de Monaco is, for all intents and purposes, virtually unchanged since its inaugural race back in 1929. The faster cars of today ensure the 19 corners past the casino and along the seafront remain as thrilling as ever. A 2.1-mile lap here takes us around an entire country, yet never more than inches from the race-ending barriers. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position. And the smooth operator Carlos Sainz completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Fernando Alonso, Leclerc, Russell, Hülkenberg, Hamilton, Oscar Piastri, Perez, Stroll, Tsunoda, Albon, Ricciardo, Ocon, Gasly, Magnussen, Norris, Bottas, Joe, and Logan Sargeant. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. And alongside me in the commentary box, my old friend, Anthony Davidson. I know what we've got to do before the start of today's race, but what about our driver? What do the final hours look like for them?
Well, for them, you know, you've got your pre-race rituals that you go through. You see different drivers that, you know, some have got their headphones on, they're listening to the music. Some drivers really absorb the energy from the crowd and they're there waving to them. Other drivers, they go within themselves. They chat to their engineers, absorbing that information, that vital information that you need to carry you through the race. And, you know, those pre-race rituals are essential to making things systematic. We do a lot of Grand Prix in a season, and the more systematic you can be, the easier you are within that environment.
Right, this track needs a lot of downforce, so we won't have as much top speed. The good news, though, is that it's going to make our DRS even more effective than normal. Try to make the most of it. In the race and quali if you can.
radio check.
Okay, so everything looks good on the power unit cycles, so let's concentrate on bringing tyres and brakes up to temperature. No rain expected, no rain expected for the time being. Okay, incredible parking there, nice one. That's going to give you the edge if you can get a good launch as the race starts. Keep an eye on the lights, the start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with a clutch. DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Let's use overtake and burn off some of this energy. No issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Right, let's not stay behind this car for too long. We need to get past. Good job, that was the fastest lap of the race so far. Keep pushing, you're gaining on the car ahead. Past, make use of the overtake button and see what you can do.
Wow, lost for words. Absolutely lost for words here.
Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 0.6 seconds. You're increasing the gap on the car behind by 0.5 a lap. Okay, Nico, engine's running too hot. Engine is running too hot. Let's keep it a bit cooler for now, please. Oh, mate, you made that look easy. Nice work. That's why I love working with you. Smashed it. We're approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. Okay, keep an eye on that gap ahead, please. 2.2 seconds. Now we're boxing this lap. Gap to your teammate behind, 18.6 seconds. The car behind started to drop back. There's a gap beginning to form. Let's make the most of it. Okay, pit in this lap and remember the speed limit. We'll be penalised if we exceed it. Keep that in mind as you approach.
And it looks like the pit crew are out in the lane and ready to perform their magic on the car. They're going to be aiming to achieve the fastest pit stop time possible. I think Haas have an issue with attaching one of the front wheels. They'll be disappointed here.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Okay, Kevin's in for his stop now. Okay, the gap behind, 5.1 seconds. No issues with tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Okay, take it easy on the car. We can't sustain this level of damage. Okay, Nico, Leclerc ahead. We don't want to let this hold us up too long, so do your best to get past and get on with the race. we're catching the car ahead, but remember, we need to get to the end of the race on these tyres. You're pulling out a second a lap on the car behind. Really good stuff. For a bit of understeer when trailing the car ahead. They're going to be giving off dirty air, which is going to affect our tyres, so try to get past. Okay, nice work. Really good job with that target, mate. Red Bull driver has just completed a pass for the lead. Okay, here's the gap that we're trailing the car ahead by. 2.0 seconds. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 18.8 seconds. We've got a 2 second gap to the car behind. We need to keep it clean so they don't get a chance to overtake. Focus. Final lap. Okay, gap to the car ahead, 4.1 seconds.
Good job, guys. Happy for that.
It's another victory and a champion's performance from Max Verstappen.
I mean, it looked like they were in a different category at points during the race, led every lap. I mean, what more can we say?
The drivers are en route to the podium as we speak. What a fantastic win for the Red Bull team. They performed exceptionally today, keeping us firmly on the edge of our seats throughout the entirety of the race. Congratulations to everybody at the team. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action, and I can't wait to see what's next.
Okay, mate, I'm pleased to say that our new parts have come through without any issue, so they'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.